Well, you know, we live in a culture today where we often see sport, especially pro sport, as kind of the poster child for vice. You see all the bad stuff, you know, envy, sloth, anger, greed, gluttony, you know, it's all there. I'll premise first by saying I've worked with pro athletes for a good part of my life, and the vast majority of them are really solid, great people that you'd love to have as friends. You just never hear about them. So I've worked with many NFL players that were first round picks, that played in Super Bowls, that won in Super Bowls. I've worked with gold medalists, I've worked with, you know, world record holders. So I mean, I've worked with, you know, really incredible athletes all my life. You just never hear about them. First round picks, never hear about them. They're great, they have great careers, just don't hear about them because they haven't shot somebody, killed somebody, done drugs, done something terrible. But that's the culture of what we think. So we think sport is bad. Big mistake. We were made to play. And a matter of fact, think about this. There's not many things you can talk about like play that every human being from the beginning of time has done. There's never been a human being that hasn't played. So you gotta ask yourself, well, why would that be? So I started to look into it. Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, Cicero, St. Francis de Sales, St. Augustine, Cardinal Henry Newman. I mean, I could go on and on with the list. It's almost like an infinite of the best minds, the best that has been written and spoken have had something to say about play. And by the way, play and sport are the same thing. There are four kinds of play. Sport is the competitive form, so sport is play. It's not, you know, play isn't for little kids and sport's for serious people. It is one form of play. And so we've been all made for this, so sport is not bad. What we're doing in it is really the problem. You know, St. Paul talks about it. You know, 1 Corinthians, he talks about our bodies being a temple. He talks about in his own life when he goes for the crown, when we talk about the imperishable crown, He says, I drive my body and I train it. I mean, what powerful words. And the reason why is that St. Paul was from Tarsus. And everybody knows in Tarsus, I'm sure, that there was a palestra, which is like an Olympic training center. So everybody listening to him would completely relate to these analogies of boxers and runners and champions and our bodies as temples and so forth, because they understood athletics. But my point here is, these things are powerful. They're part of us. God made us to play. And although we often think of great works of art, you know, if you ever got blessed enough to go to Rome and see St. Peter's, which is just incredible. It's like, it's overwhelming when you go into it. It's beyond, even if you've seen pictures of it, it can't compare to actually walking into it. And when you get there, those were made, those cathedrals, to make you look up and to think about God. I mean, to give you a scale of yourself in relation to God, you know, and have us contemplate God. Work nature, you know, great, you know, views of mountains or seas or, you know, sunsets, whatever it might be. All those things we think, oh, those make me think about God. But sport? Oh, no, we would never. Yeah, sport. Matter of fact, I was watching an athlete by the name of David Rhodesia. He was in the 2012 London Olympics. He was in the half mile. And he led from the beginning of the race, and he won in a world record time of 1:40. Now, I don't know if you know half mile times. 1:40 is like incredible for a half mile. I mean, it's phenomenal. And I could watch him, there's a loop of this. I go back and I look at it often. I could watch him do it a million times. Because I can have to tell you, while I was watching him, the beauty of that man running, the form, the strength, the perseverance, the concentration. I'll tell you what came to me. I thought, it's amazing God made a man like this in his image and likeness. So sport has this capacity to raise us up and have us contemplate the very highest things. Matter of fact, my favorite quote is by someone, I'll tell you at the end who it's by because it may surprise you, but it goes like this: sport, properly directed, develops character, makes a man courageous, a generous loser, and a gracious victor. It refines the senses, gives intellectual penetration, and steals the will to endurance. It's not merely a physical development then. Sport, rightly understood, is an occupation of the whole man. And while perfecting the body as an instrument of the mind, it also makes the mind itself a more refined instrument for the search and communication of truth, and helps man to achieve that end to which all others must be subservient, the service and praise of his creator. That is by Pope Pius XII, in an address he gave called Sport at the Service of the Spirit. That should be our motto, that should be our mission, certainly as Catholics, any Christian, we should be looking at that saying, that raises this thing, play, this sport thing, to the very highest level. It's the way that we worship and praise and honor God. So sport and play, the sport and virtue, they're not mutually exclusive. We're not saying, hey, either we need a world-class athlete or a very good person. They're not mutually exclusive. World-class performance, your best performance, that's one virtue. But we're looking for all the virtues because they work together. So the value of sport and play is we're made for it. Matter of fact, we're so wired to play, we'll even pay to watch other people do it. Think of the craziness of that. We'll go into a stadium paying money to sit there and watch other people play. That's how much we are made to play. So the important thing here is that we don't throw out the proverbial phrase, throw out the baby with the bathwater. We want to make sure that we keep sport and keep the good of the play as it was designed and made for us to play, like wisdom, played before God, played day after day. Like wisdom, we should be doing it for its own sake and not for some mean and selfish end like money, power, or fame.